Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is the narrator Ravi Gupta. Today we want to talk about CO2 fixed firefighting system. In today's topic, I will explain the CO2 system. After that, we will see how the CO2 is activated, how the pilot valve is installed, what will happen when you open the pilot door of the CO2 system, why the time delay is provided in CO2 system, and what are the power sources in CO2 system, and what are safety in CO2 system. This is the first part of the CO2 fixed firefighting system. CO2 fixed firefighting system will consist of four parts, explaining all and each and everything regarding head assembly of the CO2. Today I am explain the CO2 fixed fire system. After the next video, I will explain the head assembly of CO2. In after that video, I will explain that after actuating the CO2, or how we are going to actuate the CO2 and what are the process we are going to take. So please watch the full series. You will understand a lot. So let's begin the today video of CO2 fixed firefighting system. So as you can see in this diagram, that this is a pilot cylinder. Okay, this pilot cylinder is provided in fire control station and in CO2 system. Okay, so basically what happened, this is the CO2 bottles which is been kept, or the number is been designed depending upon the rules and regulation as per the IMO, or you can see as per the MARPOL or SOLAS. Now how it is actuated, let's see. This is the remote control panel. Okay, so basically now what is happening, through a remote control panel the pilot cylinder valve and the master valve is controlled. Okay, so what will happen first, let's see. First we have to actuate the pilot cylinder. After the pilot cylinder is actuated, the CO2 from here will go through this valve. This valve will be remotely operated by the remote control station and it will be open, and when the CO2 door is open, an alarm will go off and it will indicate that CO2 pilot door is been opened. So first let's see how it is designed. So as you can see, this is the door of the CO2 pilot cylinder. This is the pilot cylinder and the door is been provided with this alarm contact. When the door is closed, the alarm contact and the connections are not connected. When the door is open, through the spring mechanism this contact will be made. As soon as the alarm contact will be made, an alarm circuit will goes on and a engine room alarm will go, indicating that CO2 pilot cylinder door is been opened. As the CO2 pilot cylinder door will be open, the fan contact will be disconnected and the fan of the space, engine room space, will be switched off. Okay, now so if someone has opened the CO2 cabinet door or pilot cylinder door, then alarm will go on. So as soon as the pilot cylinder door is open, the alarm will go and the fan circuit will be activated off and fan will go off and alarm will be activated, indicating the release door has been open. After that, through remote control station, this valve is open. And now the CO2 from pilot cylinder will go and will come to the servo cylinder. This servo cylinder is connected through a wire mechanism to the connecting pin of the individual CO2 bottle. This connecting pin is provided in such a way that when it has been pulled in this direction by the wire, it will puncture the CO2 bottle, individual CO2 bottle, which will cause the gang release of the CO2 from the system and will be collected in this pipe. So what will happen, the pilot cylinder CO2 is coming from here and it is been pushing the servo cylinder down. As the servo cylinder is pushed down, this wire will be pushed in this direction, causing the connecting pin of the individual CO2 to puncture the CO2 cylinder. The CO2 from here will go to a master valve. This master valve is being operated by a remote control panel, and as it is open, the CO2 will go, and depending upon the engine room section area, means depending upon the area where you want to apply, such as pre-fire room, sharing room, or engine room overhead or engine room. So depending upon the area of application, means after a master valve, section valve will come. Depending upon the line of action, CO2 will go and will be actuated. Now the questions come to our mind is that, as you can see, as soon as the pilot door is open, an alarm is going. Okay, so let's see about that. We will come again back to this system again. CO2 bottle contain carbon dioxide in liquid state with a pressure of 56 bar at 20 degrees Celsius. That is very important. Means the carbon dioxide pressure should be defined always with the temperature, because as the temperature will increase, the pressure will also increase. Okay. So as the temperature increases, the pressure inside a CO2 bottle also increases. So it is very necessary to maintain correct temperature inside CO2 room. So CO2 room temperature should always be maintained around 20 to 35 degrees Celsius, so that to prevent the overpressurizing of the CO2 bottle. Each CO2 bottle consists of a 45 kg of CO2. Okay. Now at a 56 bar charge. Okay. The pressure of pilot cylinder is also same, 56 bar. Okay. Now, how the CO2 is activated? CO2 from the main bottle is activated by a CO2 pilot cylinder. As the pilot cylinder door is open, a micro switch is activated. This micro switch, okay. The micro switch will ensure that the activation of CO2 warning alarm and ventilation setup. So, this alarm will go to on, which will allow the engine room personnel and engine room personnel working inside the engine room or left in the engine room can be known that CO2 alarm has gone on. He should immediately evacuate the engine room, and the fan will go up to prevent the disbursement and to prevent the ineffectiveness. Because if the fan is on, in that case what will happen, the CO2 once injected, it will be dispersed by the fan, exhaust fan outside. So the exhaust fan will go off to ensure that the good smoothing action can be achieved. CO2 pilot cylinder consists of two pilot cylinder or bottle containing CO2 gas inside. The pressure of the CO2 inside this pilot cylinder is same as that of main CO2 bottle, that is 56 bar. Only the quantity of gas is different. Okay. So now let's see how the system is working. Before injecting CO2, it is to make sure that the non-return valve to servo cylinder and the master valve is open. This can be done remotely as well as locally. Master valve is fitted with a gas release valve which will continue to give alarm as long as CO2 passes through it. Very important. So what is happening? Before, means as the CO2 door will be open, the alarm will go and fan will be off. After that, to remote control station, this two valve, means the valve going to the servo cylinder, this should be open, and the master valve should be open. The master valve is provided with a gas alarm which will continue to alarm, give alarm as long as the CO2 will pass through the system. Means depending upon the pressure, the alarm will be actuated. This is called a pressure alarm switch. Means depending upon the CO2 going through, alarm will be activated to ensure that the CO2 is passing. Okay. Now, after ensuring that both valves are open and line are correctly set, section valve of particular section is open. The pilot valve is open, which will activate the servo cylinder via time delay circuit. Very important. Now, as I have told you, after the opening the master valve and the section valve, means where the particular section we are going to apply, the CO2 pilot cylinder bottle is punctured. The question is asked that why twin number? I will come on that later. After the pyro cylinder has been ruptured, so what will happen? The CO2 will be injected. But the CO2 after the puncturing this connecting pin, the CO2 will not immediately go through this engine room area, because time delay is provided so that to ensure that a person getting enough time if he is entrapped in that particular area to come out. Okay. When the servo cylinder is activated, it will puncture the CO2 bottle in a bulk via connecting pin, and the bulk CO2 is released and passes through the master and section valve and injected in the affected area for quick fire extinguishing. So, as I have told you, same thing. Now, as the question is asked, that why two pilot cylinder bottle is provided? It is a type of redundancy that if there is any leakage in one of the pilot bottle, the other can perform the action. Individual pilot cylinder have a capability to actuate the servo cylinder. This servo cylinder can be actuated by individual pilot cylinder bottle. Because if one pilot cylinder bottle is been punctured, that is enough to move the servo cylinder, this section, connecting pin wire section to down, this will move down to ensuring the puncturing of that CO2 in cylinder in bulk. Okay, so there are two CO2 pilot cylinder cabinet. One is local pilot cylinder cabinet and the other is main remote pilot cylinder cabinet. Means two, basically the control is two in number, means basically four pilot cylinder bottles provided, two in remote control area, two in local control area, means two in CO2 bottle, CO2 room, and two in fire control station. Basically, if we are going to actuate the CO2 system, we prefer to actuate it from the CO2 room area. If we have a scope, we will use that scope only. Okay. One more remote. Okay. Now, this facilitates the operation of CO2 flooding system from a remote place other than CO2 room. Both pilot cylinder cabinet are connected in parallel. They are, as you can see, they are connected in parallel, and a non-return valve fitted in the line prevent the backflowing of the CO2. Also, two pilot bottle are placed in a pilot cabinet. Only one is sufficient for the operation for both master and the CO2 bottle head assembly. So basically, now as you can see, this pilot cylinder bottle is connected in parallel to the line and a pressure gauge is provided. So as soon as this is open, what will happen? It will show the pressure around 56 bar, and individual unit is sufficient to actuate the CO2 or puncture the CO2 bottle. Now for nomenclature, you can see this is a CO2 cylinder bottle, which is basically available in two sizes, 1.25 2.2 kgs it can be provided. And somewhere it is provided with a knob, just you can rotate it and it will be actuated. Some is provided with a manual release to puncture it. And the connection, the line connection is of high pressure, okay. And the pressure gauge is provided, and some remote control area, the solenoid valve is provided so that it can be actuated from remote control position also. Now, as I have told you, a time delay is provided. Okay, a time delay is provided. So where the time delay will be provided? So basically the time delay will be provided here. Okay, the time delay will be provided for the gang release, means the movement of this downward will be delayed by the time delay circuit, so that to ensure the person entrapped in this area will come out. Now this will be provided in this section. Okay, in this section. Okay, so let's see now how it works. CO2 pilot cylinder cabinet is provided with a time delay for following reason. As soon as the CO2 pilot cylinder cabinet opened, alarm is sound in the protected space, that is the engine room space. A time delay of 60 to 90 seconds gives sufficient time for any personnel in the protected space to escape even after the operation of both valve in the pilot cylinder cabinet. So what happens, suppose you have in hurry, you go and just you have opened this CO2 bottle. Okay, you have just opened the door and you have just opened this valve, and the CO2 will go. If the time delay is not there, you have not taken the properly head count, you have just seen a fire and in hurry you decided to okay, I will inject the sewer system. So suppose you have opened the valve and this will go through here to a servo cylinder, but because the time delay is provided in the line, it will prevent this CO2 of 56 bar to go to actuate the servo cylinder. This servo cylinder will be actuated after a period of 60 to 90 seconds after the CO2 bottle has been punctured. Why? It is very important so that to ensure the person in the protected space can escape. Regulation as per International Code for Fire Safety System says the pre-discharge alarm can automatically activated by opening the pilot cylinder cabinet door. The alarm shall operate for a length of time needed to evacuate the space, but not in no case less than 20 seconds before the medium is released. So as soon as the CO2 cabinet door is open, the alarm will go on, and the alarm should continue to go on as long as the door is open. Okay, but in no case it should be less than 20 seconds. So a time delay of minimum 20 seconds is provided, but as a safe side, it is kept at 60 to 90 seconds. Okay, so what is happening? The CO2 from the pilot cylinder is coming, and this will, here a pressure switch is provided. This pressure switch will, as the pressure will act on this, this will make the circuit when the CO2 will come. As soon as the system is made, now through a time delay of a timer provided, depending upon that, the solenoid for the operation which is going to the puncturing the head assembly, this is decided. So basically what is happening, the pilot cylinder is coming, activating the pressure switch, and through a time delay the solenoid valve for opening the CO2 bottle, this is timing is been decided by this timer, and that is going to the CO2 head assembly. So what is happening, as you are here in this diagram, as you can see, this, when you are pressing the remote control valve, so basically as the CO2 from the here is coming through a pressure switch, it is getting actuated and ensuring that after a delay of 60 to 90 seconds, it will allow the CO2 to pass through the servo cylinder. So I hope it is clear. Okay, the time delay can be achieved in different way. Out of these, two type of time delay unit is commonly used in CO2 flooding system on board. One is electrical type, which has an AC of 220 volt power supply and a pressure switch timer and a solenoid valve. Okay, so different arrangement can be provided. Right now which you are seeing in this is a basically an AC system which has been provided, which is continuously getting supply, but a circuit is not made. As soon as circuit will make through a timer delay, it will be delayed by a period of 60 to 90 seconds, and then it will allow the CO2 coming from pyro cylinder to puncture the CO2 head assembly, and after that it will go to the master valve to a particular area. So basically what I mean to say is that we are delaying the CO2 bulk activation. Okay, this bulk activation of CO2 is been delayed by the timer, means we are performing the delay operation here, because as soon as this connecting pin is been pulled, once the CO2 is released, it cannot be controlled. So we are delaying the puncturing of connecting pin. Okay, now let's see what are the power source in the CO2 flooding system. Two separate power sources provided for CO2 flooding system. One power source is from main power unit and other power source is from emergency power unit. Each power is independent from each other, connected to main and local control panel of a CO2 flooding system. So very, very easy to understand. So as the CO2 power is very important, means it is a part of a fire control system. So it need to be provided with an emergency supply as it come in essential services. So it consists of two systems. One is the emergency power system. One is the main power system. Second is the emergency power system. So each having own connection to the fire control station. Okay. As the CO2 system power source are categorized under critical equipment, hence such arrangement is provided. Very easy. Now let's see what are safety in CO2 flooding system. Master valve with the alarm switch. This alarm is a pressure type alarm which will continue to go on as long as the CO2 passing through the system. Relief valve in the manifold. A relief valve is provided in the manifold. Why it is provided, I will tell in the next video. A stop valve and pull handle are in lock release cabinet and alarm switch. As simple as that, means basically as soon as the cabinet door is open, alarm will go on. Safety bursting disc at CO2 bottle. It is provided so that if the temperature increases, in that case a safety bursting disc is provided which will burst and will release the excess pressure in the CO2 bottle. Leakage detecting pressure switch on the manifold, very important. Non-Newton discharge valve after the bottle. So these are basically the safeties which are provided. Each individual reason of fitting the safety I will explain in my next video. So please remain tuned till the next video. The whole CO2 system will be explained. Okay, and if you want to read this article, means what I have told you today, if you want to read this in article form, you can visit the marinelation.com. This is a site. Marinelation.com is a site of a marine engineering hub, from where each article which has been published in a video form in Marine Engineering Hub, you can there go and you can find it also in a article form. Both in video and article form is available here. There you can go and watch from there also. If you like the video, please do hit the like button. Please do subscribe and press the bell icon so that you can get the notification each time I am placing any video. If you like it, please do subscribe and please share on with your friend in a Facebook and WhatsApp account. Have a good day, friend.